So today we're going to talk about the simple act of seeing something on the ground, bending over and picking it up, and how you're doing that. This is something that we often think about or we consider, what's the shape of my spine when I see my sock on the ground and I need to reach over and pick it up. It's important that we consider these things because a healthy body is one that can easily withstand everyday wear and tear into old age. So everyday wear and tear is something like reaching down and picking something up off the floor. This could be something as simple as an item of clothing, or it could be a child that you're reaching and pulling out of the car, or it could be lifting a box at work, something like this. So it's important that we establish how to actually position the body in a way that's healthy and that is sustainable, and that's where this comes in. So what we're going to work on today is our stick deadlift, and this is something that we do quite often in our fitness classes as a way to re-establish the functional movement patterns of the body. So again, you can move and do everything that you need to do throughout your day without causing yourself unnecessary pain or discomfort. So we're going to use the stick, and what you want to do is place the stick along the spine. You want to make sure that the stick makes 3 points of contact on the body. The first point is going to be just at the top of the butt crack. The second point is going to be into the thoracic spine, which is the middle area of the spine. And the third point is going to be the back of the head. Now, just as important is the points that you do not want to touch the spine. So that's why I have my hand here. There should be a gap. It shouldn't be a huge gap because that's going to pull my upper back, my middle spine rather, away from the stick. Okay? Nor should it be too close so that you lose that gap. You want to make sure that the hand can comfortably fit through while you maintain top of the butt crack touching the stick, middle spine touching the stick, back of the head touching the stick, back of the neck has a curve, lower back has a curve. This is your natural curve of the spine. So this is what you want to maintain. You're going to position your feet and then work into your deadlift position. So there's not even any weight at all, just reestablishing in the brain how the body is designed to move and trying to come back to that. So setting up the feet, getting those points of contact in the stick, making sure you can slide your hand through the lumbar spine, but keeping the upper back, that middle spine onto the stick, and then going ahead and starting to take the weight onto the heels, bringing the body forward, and then inhale to come up here. Again, shifting the weight back onto the heels, and then coming up as you inhale. Trying that a couple of times, bringing the weight back onto the heels, making sure that the upper back, the middle area of the spine there, is not losing contact, and coming up. This is such a good exercise to do, and something that should be done across all exercise modalities, regardless of whether you're doing yoga or fitness or anything like that, especially if you find that you're extra mobile in your spine. Sometimes you've actually lost this idea of what the natural curve in your spine should be. So this little guy, so good. Come in and give it a try in the class.